Known and famous mythology speaks about a big bird called the Phoenix. That bird lives for 1,000 years. After the 1,000 years are over, it puts itself to flames and burns itself to death. But then, interestingly, it again regenerates itself and reborn from the ashes and lives for another 1,000 years to go again for that life cycle. That big bird also does not have any mate. It's a male bird and does not reproduce. It just lives by itself. In some places in the Torah, we found about a bird called Of HaChol, the bird of Chol. What is that bird? It says in the Pasuk in Eyov, when he was in the midst of his pain and suffering, he said, Va'omar, im kini egva, ve'kachol arbe yamim. Just like the Chol, I would live a long life. What is that Chol? Rashi says, on that Pasuk in Eyov, kachol arbe yamim, of sheshmo Chol. There's a bird, his name is Chol. Lo niknesa alav mita. He did not get the punishment to die that was given to Adam HaRishon. Why is that? Why this bird was exempt from the death penalty of Adam HaRishon? He says, "Shelo ta'am me'etz hadat, ulefosof 1,000 shanim mitchadesh vechozer lenaruto." Rashi, this bird did not eat from etz hadat that Chava offered everybody. Chava didn't offer only Adam HaRishon from etz hadat, but it offered also everything living. And this is how the Midrash says. The Midrash says that Chava wanted to feed everybody, and that bird did not agree to eat from that etz hadat. Bereshit Rabba, echila et ha-behema, et ha-chaya ve-et ha-ofot. Chava offered the fruit of etz hadat to everybody. Animals, birds. Kulam shamula. Everybody ate from it, except the chol. And because of that, says Rabbi Yonai, every 1,000 years it regenerates itself and reborn, because it did not get the punishment to die. But that is not exactly the way Shem, the son of Noach, explained what happened to that bird. In the Gemara in Sanhedrin Kufret Amud Bet, the Gemara quotes that Noach, after the lengthy journey of the Teva, came out and he had all the animals with him. But there was one bird that was different than all other animals and birds, and that is that of HaChol, the bird of the Chol, which is also called Orshina. And that was different because it got a bracha from Noach, a blessing from Noach. What was the bracha that Noach gave her? That she should live forever. Unlike other creatures that die after their life, but that bird, for some reason, regenerates itself and relives life over and over again. Why is that? Says Shem, the son of Noach, the following story. He says that one time his father Noach was walking around the Teva, the ark, and he saw in a separate room that bird, the Orshina, the Chol, and he saw it sitting there hungry, and he remembers that it didn't come to ask for food for many, many days. And he was wondering, why is it that this bird does not ask any food? And he approached and said the following, Ashkache Abba Degani Besafna Detivuta. He found the bird sitting in a separate place, a separate cell in that Teva. Amala lo bat mezone? You don't want any food? Why are you not coming to ask for food? Amma amrale chazitich davetrida amina lotz atzarich. I saw that you are so busy, therefore I said I would not cause you any more aggravation, and I let it go, and I would sit without any food. Noach was mitpael. He was so excited to hear that such a bird, such a creature that does not ask for food in order not to disturb anybody, and he told her, "Marla yerava delotamut, should be ratzon milifnei Hakadosh Baruch Hu, that you should never die." But that seems to be contradicting one the other, because before we said that Shem, the son of Noach, said that the bird lives forever, because of the blessing of Noah. And right now we're saying it's because the bird didn't eat from Etz Hadat, and Mimele, it wasn't under that punishment to die. How does that work? That's a question of the Maharsha. But the Maharal says that it's not contradicting, because Noah didn't actually give the bracha to the bird, but rather Noah was mitba'el from that feature of the bird, from that character trait of humility that a bird has, and he told her, I see you have the qualities to live forever. How is that quality gives you a lengthy life? That's because the Gemara says that whenever a person has the midah of shiflut, humility, everybody loves him. If everybody loves him, says the Maharal Miprag, that is something that brings you a long life, because when everybody loves you, when everybody wants your company, when nobody opposes you, when you have no enemies, such a thing, says the Maharal Miprag, will bring you a lengthy and happy life. And that's what teaches us over here, that although that mythology, the Greek mythology, is correct because we have the same sources in the Torah, but the Goyim don't have an idea why that bird lives forever. Our sources tell us also why the bird lives forever and what we can learn from it. And that's a beautiful musar for each and one of us. The more you have friends, the less you have enemies, the lengthier and happier life would be.